Welcome back, everyone, to the Derby build, and we have gone electric. I picked up a QS138 motor and a VOTOL EM200 controller. This is rated at 3,000 watts or 4 horsepower, but you can push it all the way up to 17 to 25, which would give you around 30 horse. Crazy. This is just a really quick rundown because I haven't seen a good video showing the components and how to connect it. First, you have the QS138 motor. This is great. It bolts into a pit bike frame. It uses common sprockets and it has a gear reduction, so you don't need to run a huge goofy sprocket. Second, you have the VOTOL EM200 controller, and this can push 200 amps. So that's really powerful. It's great. Then it does come with a throttle. I'm not gonna use this throttle, but they sent it anyways. And it came with a display, which I'm also not gonna use, but they sent it anyways. Also came with a DC to DC converter. This converts 72 volts down to 12 volts, so you can run lights, which is really nice if you're doing a build for the street. I just wanna run through these wires really quick. From your battery, and I am using a temporary battery, you put the positive here, you put the negative here. Super simple. Then from your motor, you have your phase wires. The blue goes to U, green goes to V, and yellow goes to W. Super simple. This is your wiring harness from the controller. Plugs in, super simple. There's not a lot of information on the internet about which wires go where. To turn the controller on, you need a wire from the battery positive to this purple wire. Anytime that's connected, it'll be on. So put a switch in here like your key. So in this case, the battery positive goes to the key, turn the key on, and then it goes to this purple wire, the single purple wire. That's your on-off switch. Next, you have your throttle. That is as simple as this three plug, which is black, green, pink, and that goes to your throttle, which is black, green, red. If you have a different throttle, you'll probably still have a black on the bottom and a red or a pink on the top, and put your odd color in the middle. This big hunk is your hall sensor that's connected to the motor. The hall sensor, the throttle, and the battery positive to the purple is all you need to run. Turn the key on. You have your voltage. This one is black and white, black and brown, green and white, and this is your three-speed control. If you have a little switch to switch between three speeds, you plug that in here, and that'll give you high, medium, and low. I believe the middle black brown is ground, so when you connect that to the green or the black, you get the two other speeds, and when you don't connect to anything, you get low speed. This blue, black, brown, and orange is your USB programming port. This did come with a nice USB programming one. You just plug that in, plug this in your computer, and do the program that way. This black and brown is actually your high speed turbo switch or whatever. This will give you full amperage. Right now, with this stock programming, that'll give you 200 amps. So that's pretty quick. 200 amps is 19 horsepower at 72 volts. One more item to show how to wire. This is the DC to DC converter. Gives you 72 to 12 volt. Connect this guy to your battery positive, 72 volts. Connect this one to your battery negative, and then this will output 12 volts DC. I did not order the display with this, so I don't think I'm actually gonna hook it up, but this is really cool. It comes with a harness that plugs in right there, and then it actually comes with more connectors, so you can make custom connections to whatever you need to monitor. It's pretty simple. I may do a video on how to connect this as well if I end up using it, or if I just want to mess around with it. My next step is to get all this mounted in the Derby and then to build a actual bigger battery. I have to build a battery that can actually handle 200 amps, and so that will be a little bit challenging, but I found a BMS that can do that, and I think I'll be able to make that battery happen. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this video helped. I know that when I was looking for information on this, it was kind of hard to find. So hopefully it helps you. Please like and subscribe and buy me a coffee if you can.